And also, in of course, in our sports discussions, Jose Mourinho's side, Tottenham Hotspur, of course, got a victory against Chelsea yesterday on penalties, 5-4. Frank Lampard's young Chelsea side took the lead in the 19th minute through Timo Werner. The German scored his first goal for the Blues after arriving for a £55 million fee from RB Leipzig. Spurs, of course, then fought back and got an equaliser through Eric Lamela in the 84th minute, which took the match to a penalty shootout.
Did they deserve the victory, Tottenham?
Look, with the way the game went, it was a tightly contested encounter. And then, look, both teams were just going at it. It was a full-on attacking match. But then one thing was sure, that both teams were not solid defensively, especially Chelsea. A lot of individual errors were there. But then I must give kudos to Jose Mourinho. He did a number on his protege, Frank Lampard. And then he was playing mind games a lot. Before the game, Mourinho did say that, you know what, I feel that my team is not ready. We've had a lot of games. We've been playing Europa League games. And then fatigue will set in. Fitness levels are not the best. However, he was able to actually just pick certain players who were up to par in terms of 100% fitness. He left Harry Kane on the bench, left Lucas Moura on the bench. Heung-min Song was already injured. And then with the selection, the way he set up his team with a three at the back, look, it was just simply fantastic. They had a good balance of defense and attack. However, coming to Chelsea, they started the match brightly with a great goal from Timo Werner, well dispatched. Look, the pressure was on him. When you come from Germany and coming to England for that fee, and everyone, look, we all know your goal scoring record. 64 goals in about 99 appearances for RB Leipzig. That was simply fantastic. So everyone expected him to hit the ground running. After three games, no goal. Everyone's wondering what's happening. So that was a huge weight off his back. But then I believe it was down to... Yeah, definitely well dispatched. But then I believe it was down to tactical assessment. And that's up to Lampard. He needs to find a way in which whenever he picks a certain 11 or any crop of players, they must be able to communicate properly, especially from the back. I believe that's why he brought Thiago Silva in. He needed a leader at the back. However, Kurzawa and Fikayo Tomori, both young players, were not able to lead the line from the back. Edouard Mendy, being a new player as well, was not really able to organize his defense. So he had a lot of lapses, especially from Azpilicueta. And also Emerson, who came on later on. And as far as I'm concerned, he was the culprit for the goal. Eric Lamela was just brilliant. Just behind him, kept quiet. Exactly. We're just waiting for the assist from Sergio Reguilón. And then immediately he got the ball, well dispatched. And then going into the penalties, you know, it's all about mind games, really, at the penalties. And then we saw a lot of time that the Spurs players dispatched the penalty to the right-hand side of Mendy. But then he kept going the wrong way. And then when he finally decided to go to the left way, Harry Kane dispatched the other way.
I wish I could, you know, I wish I was a sport analyst this morning. so much that I really want to say, because I watched the game and I saw that, you know, the first five or six penalties went the same direction.
Exactly.
Both keepers kept going the wrong way. Mm-hmm. And it was interesting to see which keeper is going to move this way first, you know, but it was interesting to watch. What about Frank Lampard? You know, do you think he would, you know, keep his job, or maybe there might be plans to...
You know, first of all, him leaving Derby County and coming to Chelsea, there was an assurance as to the time limit in which he would be at Chelsea. However, there were goals and objectives. You take a look at his first season was simply brilliant. A top four finish, got all the way to the FA Cup final. That was good enough. But now, with the amount of money he has spent, he needs to win trophies. Nothing less than winning trophies is not good enough. Is he the right man to lead Chelsea going forward? He has the charisma. He has the experience. He has the right mentality. However, when it comes down to tactics, he's going to be questioned.
Can Tottenham go ahead to win the cup?
It really depends on how their season goes so far. Currently, they are competing in about four competitions, the Premier League, the FA Cup, the Carabao Cup, and then the Europa League. They are going through qualification stages. They don't have a huge squad, and you need quality in depth to go on to win trophies. However, Mourinho is a brilliant tactician and he knows the best way in which to win this trophy. This was the first trophy he won when he came to England, you know, with Chelsea. So definitely a lot to look forward to, but then their chances of winning is good enough, but then they'll need to do a whole lot more to get all the way to the final.
I also want you to quickly speak on the new keeper, Chelsea keeper from last night. Kepa, of course, has had to take a break. Was his performance impressive?
It was brilliant, brilliant performance. I take a look at his frame, 6'4", same height as Peter Cech, and Peter Cech has been working closely with him. I could see that definitely when it comes to reactions, he's very, very sharp. When it comes to organizing the wall for set pieces, he's very attentive, doesn't speak so much of English, but knows how to command his players. And then his concentration in the match for me was simply sublime. He was able to concentrate for 90 minutes. A lot of goalkeepers sometimes switch off in a game, but for him to do that at that young age and have that mentality and character, that's fantastic. But then the most important thing about Edouard Mendy is the ball playing.
I know if I leave the both of you, this conversation will not end. So I will have to interject and say thank you very much, Okwe, for coming on The Breakfast this morning.
Thank you for having me.
Hello. Hope you enjoyed the news. Please do subscribe to our YouTube channel and don't forget to hit the notification button so you get notified about fresh news updates.